I'm here at the Biohacker Summit with Rhonda Patrick. Rhonda Patrick, your talk was about saunas and cold thermogenesis. What brought you to Helsinki?
Well, I was invited to give a talk here at this Biohacker conference, and because I'm very interested in the sauna and heat stress, and also I'm interested in cold stress, Helsinki is a place to come because there's more saunas here than people, and the sauna culture is so ubiquitous. So I was really interested to see what that was like. And so I actually experienced yesterday, I went to the Sauna Society they have here in Helsinki, where they have these like many different saunas that are overlooking the Baltic. And there's like traditional smoke saunas, and then they have hot saunas where they add, you know, the water and it gets really hot. All sorts of saunas. And so we went around and tried the different saunas out, and it was women only this day. So they sort of rotate between women and men. But it was just really interesting to see all the women and how like, you know, they seem to really, the sauna was really a part of their culture. I mean, and they would do the sauna and then they'd walk out and they'd jump into the Baltic and they come back and then go into the sauna again. And so it's just kind of observing and experiencing as well, this culture. And it's really cool because I've been very interested in saunas for a long time, many, many years. So to come to a country where it's, you know, where I don't have to, you know, people, in the United States, when I talk about the sauna to some people, they're like, well, oh yeah, there's one at my gym, you know. It's like not very common, but here it's very much part of the culture. So that's what brought me here.
Yeah. Because there are a lot of health benefits to taking a sauna 2 or 3 times a week, right?
Yeah, so today I talked about some of the health benefits on the brain. So that's what initially got me interested in the sauna, was I noticed that it was really lowering anxiety and making me feel really good. So I started to read about what it was doing to the brain and started to understand a little bit more about how the sauna is changing the way your brain responds to endorphins by making you increase another endogenous opioid that doesn't make you feel so good, called dynorphin. The reason you make dynorphin is to, when you're in the sauna or experiencing heat stress in general, is because it cools you down, but it also makes you feel really uncomfortable. So it's kind of responsible for that uncomfortable feeling that you feel when you're in the sauna. You're like, oh, I'm so hot, I just want to get out. You know, that's dynorphin. But there's a biological response in the brain that changes the way your receptors that bind to endorphin are, how they're responding to endorphin. So it makes them more sensitive, so that when you release endorphin, there's lasting effects and you feel even better than you would if you hadn't had, you know, had that dynorphin. So that got me into it. And as I started to read more and more about it, I started to read studies that showed that sauna use was associated with overall longevity. And like you mentioned, frequency of sauna use seemed to really be associated with overall longevity. So there was a study that came out of Finland that studied middle-aged men that were using the sauna, you know, frequently, and also they followed these middle-aged men for 20 years and looked at, you know, various diseases that were non-accidental that they died of. And what the study found is that men that used the sauna 2 to 3 times a week had a 27% lower cardiovascular-related mortality compared to men that used the sauna 1 time a week. Men that used the sauna 4 to 7 times a week had a 50% lower cardiovascular-related mortality compared to men that only used the sauna 1 time a week. I mean, that's very robust. And then overall, all-cause mortality was also looked at. And so men that used the sauna 2 to 3 times a week had a 24% lower all-cause mortality. Men that used it 4 to 7 times a week had a 40% lower all-cause mortality than men that used it once a week. So there is something very interesting going on here that's affecting overall longevity, not just cardiovascular-related health. And, you know, this is dose-dependent, so obviously the more frequent the sauna use, the more stronger the effect. Also, a lot of other potential confounding factors were corrected for, so physical activity, obesity, cholesterol, smoking, alcohol use, socioeconomic status, all those things were also looked at. You know, so the data really does reflect the sauna use. So that's, you know, there's a lot of mechanisms that can explain that. So cardiovascular health is improved because plasma volume increases and blood flow increases to the heart. And this lowers cardiovascular strain. And what that means is every time your heart beats, it has to do less work to pump blood to other tissues to deliver oxygen to your tissues, because that's what, you know, your heart's doing. So it's lowering cardiovascular strain, it's lowering blood pressure, it's improving endothelial cell function. So there's lots of ways that it's improving cardiovascular health. It's also very similar to aerobic exercise. When you get in the sauna, your heart rate elevates to 100 and 150 beats per minute, which really is very similar to moderate intensity physical activity. So, you know, there's a lot of overlap between physical activity and using the sauna. And then the overall longevity is super interesting. We don't really know the mechanism why people are dying less of cancer and neurodegenerative disease and respiratory diseases. But I have a couple of theories out there based on animal research. We know in animals and lower organisms that heat increases heat shock proteins, increases FOXO3. These are proteins and genetic pathways that are associated with aging well, so they staves off aging and helps with longevity because they activate many different stress response pathways in our body that help us, you know, deal with oxidants, deal with inflammation, deal with all sorts of damage and get rid of it so that it's not damaging ourselves. So it's possible that's one of the reasons, but we don't really know exactly why the sauna is affecting overall longevity, but it's super interesting.